Xôm chênh lũ mê thư vi bản to.
Excuse me, Councillor. Because we are so pressed for time, if I may cut in just with two small questions, I believe it will save the time rather than rewinding in our minds, because it pertains to this period. Mr. Witness, could you clarify for the bench, when did you become the Deputy Chief of Staff? Was it specifically, do you remember the year?
ការបរិឆេទទេចាំខែឆ្នាំណាទេប្រហែលជាខ្ញុំមិនចាំបាទទេវាយូរឆ្នាំពេកដែរហើយគេថាដឹងថាក្រោយពីសន្និបាតបើក្រោយពីសន្និបាតនៅភ្នំពេញហើយដឹងតែប៉ុណ្្នឹងបាទតែខែប្រហែលជាចុងឆ្នាំ
Would this be then after the liberation of Phnom Penh?
Or before?
One more question on this part of your testimony. You mentioned three persons who were aware of the weapons warehouse,
who
amassed and placed the weapons there. Is this then correct to understand that weapons were physically carried by other people? In addition to you.
But what nung the hen lunol tlopra.
Moved the weapons to the warehouse.
Alone? ពេលលើកឡើងឡានពីចំការជេកទៅគឺមានកម្លាំងនៅចំការជេកជួយលើកដាក់ឡានប៉ុន្តែបေါ်ឡានទៅគឺបေါ်តែខ្ញុំម្នាក់ឯងទេទៅដល់ឃ្លាំងកន្លែងធ្វើថ្មីនោះគឺមានតាតាបីអ្នកជាអ្នកជួយរើចុះហើយជាអ្នកលៀបប្រេងលៀបខ្លាញ់រៀបបិឈរទុកក្នុងឃ្លាំងបាទ
Thank you, Judge Millar.
For sake of clarity, I will move a whole chapter now
and come back to that later because of time reasons. The attack on the Pusat and what happened at Pochrey. So we'll come back to that. Mr. Witness, I'm asking you now questions. I'm asking now questions as to the reasons behind the storage of these weapons. What was the rationale for storage in a hidden way of these weapons? What were you, him, and others supposed to do with these weapons?
ត្រូវយកអាវុធនេះទៅប្រើប្រាស់ដោយរបៀបណាក្នុងគោលបំណងអ្វីដែរបាទគឺអ្នកដតីអត់បានយកប្រើប្រាស់ទេហើយរស់ញឹមក៏អត់បានយកប្រើប្រាស់ដែរព្រោះអាវុធដែលកាលពីធ្វើសង្គ្រាមកាន់នៅជាប់ដៃទាហាននៅមានទាំងអស់នេះជាអាវុធជាជប៉ុនទេហើយក្រោយមកដែលខ្ញុំ
Was that the original intention to hide these weapons?
So that Nim, you, and others, would start an armed rebellion against Pol Pot? បាទកាលនោះគឺវាអត់មានលក្ខវុធមានបំណងយ៉ាងម៉េចគឺខ្ញុំអត់ដឹងទេប៉ុន្តែខ្ញុំគាត់ថាខ្ញុំជាអ្នករក្សាឃ្លាំងអាវុធទុកដាក់ឲ្យបានល្អតែប៉ុណ្ណឹងតែក្រោយមកដែលខ្ញុំយកប្រើប្រាស់វិញក្រោយដែលគេចាប់ខ្ញុំពីរដងចាប់ខុស ចាប់ច្រឡំក្នុងឆ្នាំ78ពេលនោះខ្ញុំក៏សម្រេចចិត្តថាខ្ញុំមិនអាចនៅជាមួយពលពតបានទៀតទេមិនអាចនៅជាមួយរបស់ញឹមបានទៀតទេខ្ញុំក៏ពីប្រមូលកម្លាំងដែលសេសសល់និងកម្លាំងដែលគេដកយកទៅកាប់ចាការធ្វើស្រែនឹងទៀតចំឡើងវិញដើម្បីការពារ និយាយរួមគឺដំបូងថាទៅធ្វើចៅព្រៃទេយកលួចអង្គសហករហូបលួចអង្គប៉ុន្តែដល់ទៅខ្ញុំវាយទៅក៏នាំគ្នាទៅច្រើនទៅក៏ខ្ញុំទៅយកអាវុធនៅនឹងទៅយកមកចាយចាយទៅបាទ
Witness, I'll move on a little bit. You have given testimony to the investigators or the investigating judge that you, at one point in time between 75 and 79, took with you thousands of Northwest Zone troops and started an armed rebellion against the center. Is that correct?
Une remarque, Monsieur le Président. Notre confrère semble faire référence à des événements qui se sont passés en 1978. Or, le cas 2-1 concerne la période 75, décembre 77. Les politiques de l'entreprise commune sur lesquelles la Chambre de première instance s'est penchée s'arrêtent en décembre 1977. L'entreprise criminelle commune et sa composition s'arrêtent en décembre 1977. Donc il faut être clair à partir de maintenant, si nous commençons à poser des questions sur ce qui s'est passé après 1977, nous sommes complètement hors champ du procès 2-1. Nous avons un procès 2-2 uniquement dédié à ces questions, mais si nous commençons à déborder et aller au-delà de décembre 1977, cela ne sera d'aucune utilité pour la Cour suprême dans l'appréciation de la peine. Je vous demande donc de demander aux partis de ne pas poser de questions sur une période qui ne correspond pas au procès de 1.
Monsieur le Président, Mesdames, Messieurs, la Cour, je vous demande de bien écouter ce qui vient d'être dit par l'avocat des partis civils. C'est capital. D'abord, décembre 1977, c'est une date qui a été fixée de manière totalement arbitraire par la chambre de première instance pour la fin des deuxièmes déplacements de population. Mais surtout, ce qui vient d'être dit et le débat qui est en train de naître devant vous, c'est l'essence même des difficultés qui résultent de la disjonction. Et ce que vient de dire ma consoeur pour les partis civils, tous les gens qui sont dans cette salle ne sont pas forcément d'accord. Monsieur le procureur n'est certainement pas du tout d'accord avec cela. Et nous avons là un vrai problème. Je n'irai pas plus loin, nous avons développé tout cela dans le cadre de notre appel, mais il nous semble qu'en direct, à l'instant même, nous voyons les difficultés qui sont les nôtres.
Monsieur le Président, si vous me permettez de répondre deux secondes, parce que c'est effectivement important, je me réfère simplement au jugement dont il a été fait appel et sur lequel vous aurez à vous prononcer. Et le jugement est clair, à plus de 15 paragraphes, il est indiqué que les faits s'arrêtent en décembre 1977, les constatations de la Chambre sur les politiques de l'entreprise criminelle commune s'arrêtent en décembre 1977, que la composition de l'entreprise criminelle commune s'arrête en décembre 1977. C'est absolument limpide quand on lit le jugement.
The question seeks to explore the relationship of between the commanding structures of the Khmer Rouge, and we want to hear the answer. This dispute doesn't help us manage the time.
Thank you, Judge Ballard. The question, Mr. Witness, was were these arms used by you and the 2,000 plus armed forces that you took into the mountains sometime between 1975 and 1979 to fight Pol Pot, the center, if you want to call it like this?
Your Honor, I object to the question. Council knows that the witness returned from China in 1977, and he I believe just stated it was 1978 after he was arrested twice, that he decided to go to the forest. And so stating 1975 to 1979, it's quite clear what the testimony is. It was 1978 and later.
Well, I don't think so.
So that's why I formulated it neutrally and between 1975 and the jurisdiction.
So I think I'm entitled to ask the questions relating to these 2 years, 75-79. So, Mr. Witness,
did you use these weapons at an earlier store, these 20,000 weapons from former Burma?
អាវុធនេះមិនមែនលាក់ទុកសម្រាប់តស៊ូប្រឆាំងជាមួយប៉ុលពតទេដំបូងគឺទុកដាក់ឲ្យបានល្អប៉ុណ្្នឹងទេតែក្រោយពេលដែលទៅចាប់ខ្ញុំពីរដងខ្ញុំរមុខអ្នកចាប់អត់ឃើញចាប់លើកទី1ចំមនុស្សប្រធានរបស់ខ្ញុំមនុស្សប្រធានកុមារពូកាលនឹងខ្ញុំចាំកុមារមេងកំប្រែ ใบใบบาลใบวงอ้อสู้ตัวมันเหม็นเข้มมันเปลี่ยนมาวิ่งเปลี่ยนมาวิ่งไอ้มาปรับเข้มเข้มตาเอื้อเตะไอ้นอนนาตาเต้าสายล่างมาประมาณปีไงบางเข้มโรมาโตบางจีเข้มมาสู้เอายิ้มนึ่งชั่นนำจัดสบายใหญ่ถ้าหาตะไว้เอาไอ้เอาไปจับเข้ม ก็ถ้าก็ดังดีดังจังกำท่าบอกเธอเอาเธอเมย์เหมือนดังกิจจับจังจังมันไปเปียออกมาปียอบแล้วสมองยีจะบ้าบอกท่าเอาไอ้เมียมันนองจับเข้มคือบังเข้มสำหรับตัวนึงเต้าแต่บอกบังเข้มมันสลับเต้คือ khom mien vithi phsei nhai khom ko mun ye ai chan khom ko bo tu vinh tau ban pa hal chea ma tit khoy te chap mdong tiet chap chom koma chntuong bo khom chlom tha khom dai pua te chap pi tang pi leuk ni khu chap no pel yup plop plop ste chap tam phlau មកពីបូមទឹកដាក់ស្រូវហើយខ្ញុំបានមកសួរគាត់ម្ដងទៀតខ្ញុំថាលើកនេះលើកទី2ហើយសូមនិយាយពិតហើយគាត់នៅតែបដិសេធថាគាត់អត់ដឹងហើយខ្ញុំក៏ដោះកំភ្លើងមកខ្ញុំដកឲ្យគាត់ខ្ញុំដកយកក្របតែមួយក្របទេខ្ញុំឲ្យគាត់7ក្របនឹងថាបាញ់ខ្ញុំហើយទៅខ្ញុំទុកមួយក្របបាញ់អូឯងវិញតែបាញ់ក្នុងពេលក្របបាញ់ថ្មីឲ្យងាប់ទៅហើយមកងាប់មិនងាប់ទេខ្ញុំបាញ់វិញហើយមួយក្របនេះខ្ញុំយកកំភ្លើងពីអូឯងខ្ញុំបាញ់វិញហើយហើយគាត់ក៏មិនឆ្លើយតបគាត់ថាអញមិនដែលចាប់កូនខ្លួនឯងទេមានតែពួកសន្តិសុខមកឆឹមទេអ្នកខ្ញុំថាឥឡូវចាប់ពីថ្ងៃនឹងទៅអត់មានឪមានកូនទៀតទេខ្ញុំសម្រេចចិត្តថាខ្ញុំតស៊ូប្រឆាំងអង្គការវិញហើយកាលនោះខ្ញុំមិនទាន់ហៅពលពតទេខាងអង្គការវិញហើយអ្នកណាដែលតាមខ្ញុំទៅជាមួយខ្ញុំបានអ្នកណាដែលមិនទៅហើយទៅតាមរឿងខ្ញុំគឺខ្ញុំបាញ់វិញហើយប្រាប់គាត់ប៉ុណ្ណឹងហើយគាត់ថាឯងកុំធ្វើអីលឿនពេកខ្ញុំថាមិនលឿនម៉េចបើចាប់អស់លីងអញ្ចឹងហ្នឹងហៅមករៀនសូនពេញបាត់ហៅមករៀនសូនពេញបាត់ហើយខ្ញុំក៏សម្រេចចិត្តចេញទៅពេលនោះហើយដែលធ្វើឲ្យខ្ញុំមានគំនិតចាប់ដើមយកអាវុធ20,000ដើមហ្នឹងប្រើប្រាស់ឡើងវិញទៅទៅក្នុងពេលហ្នឹងទេបាទលោកមេធាវី
Mr. Witness, leaving aside for a moment the conflict, apparent conflict with your foster father, leaving aside the use of the weapons, leaving aside your arrest for a moment, do you know when plans were made for the first time to rebel? And who was behind these plans?
មកផែនការបះបោនេះគឺគ្មានអ្នកណានៅពីក្រោយទេគឺធ្វើដោយខ្លួនឯងដោយថារស់នៅក្នុងរបបអង្គការនឹងលេខបានហើយពួកបាត់មិត្តជាច្រើនយុទ្ធមិត្តជាច្រើនកាលនោះគេហៅមិត្តចឹងមានហៅបងហៅប្អូនទេហៅតែមិត្តសមមិត្តបាត់អស់ហើយមករៀនភ្នំពេញបាត់ហើយដល់ទៅចាប់ខ្ញុំចាប់ទៅចេះតែទេវតាដូចជួយខ្ញុំដែរចាប់មិនបានខ្ញុំក៏សម្រេចចិត្តថាយកអាវុធនឹងប្រើទៅហើយអត់មានអ្នកណានៅពីក្រោយខ្នងខ្ញុំទេមានតែខ្ញុំទេអង្វរគាត់អង្វរទាំងតាប៉ែតអង្វរទាំងតាគឺអង្វរទាំងតាញឹមថាឲ្យប្រឆាំងនឹងអង្ការទៅហើយខ្ញុំអង្វរតាប៉ែតនៅផ្ទះគាត់ទៅធ្វើមេដឹកនាំខ្ញុំឡើងវិញទៅនៅក្នុងព្រៃតស៊ូឡើងវិញគាត់ថាគាត់ចាស់ហើយគាត់ទៅមិនបានទេខ្ញុំទៅវល់តើគឺថាអង្ការអាចឆ្លោស៊ីកូនឯងហើយ ខ្ញុំមិននៅទេខ្ញុំចេញតស៊ូប្រឆាំងវិញហើយហើយទៅធ្វើមេដឹកនាំខ្ញុំទៅគាត់ថាអញទៅតឯងអូទៅតឯងនឹងយ៉ាប់ចាំមើលភាសាគ្នាសិនអញ្ចឹងទៅខ្ញុំក៏សម្រេចចិត្តថាខ្ញុំទៅអត់មានអ្នកណាដឹកនាំនៅពីក្រោយខ្ញុំទេអត់មានទេបាទ
Mr. Witness, it's all very interesting what you're saying, but isn't it true, when I put that to you, that sometime in the summer of 75, August 75, your foster father, Nim, together with Sopim, Von Vet, possibly Khoi and others started talking, starting having plans to openly rebel against the government or the soon-to-be government. Is that correct?
ក្រោយឆ្នាំ 75 មកពេលឡើងមកសន្និបាតនៅពេញហ្នឹងគាត់បានជួបគ្នានៅប្រកីកាឡាណោះខ្ញុំក៏ជូនគាត់មកដល់ហ្នឹងដែរហើយគាត់ទៅជជែកគ្នាបញ្ហាមិនថាទៀបចំការបះបោទេ
That was, according to you, the goal of the ultimate rebellion. Is it correct that the means to...
The witness did not confirm that the rebellion was discussed at the time.
Absolutely misstating the testimony.
If we could correct it.
I will rephrase, Your Honor. Were plans, do you know of plans at one point in time to assassinate Pol Pot, to sabotage the revolution by spreading chaos, both internally, externally, for instance by conducting a phony war with Thailand, ultimately to stage a coup d'etat? Do you know anything about such plans, whether they existed in the second half of
1975?
Have you ever heard of plans to combine forces from the East Zone and the former North Zone to attack Pochintung Airport, to attack the radio station, Radio Phnom Penh, at some time, early
77?
Do you have any recollection as to the role of neighboring country Vietnam, the role that Vietnam was to play in relation to an armed uprising?
Vietnam.
Have you ever heard of a man, Vietnamese communist cadre called Hay So?
Vietnam management Hay So that it is.
But him at night, Lute Bosu Lu. So at night, Lute.
I apologize for my pronunciation, Mr. Witness. Hey Su, does this name ring a bell to you?
Hai So.
Hai Su. So.
This Hay Su, I'm trying to refresh your memory, was a Vietnamese expert in guerrilla warfare, later member of the Standing Committee of the Communist Party of Cambodia, Vietnam, excuse me. Does that ring a bell? Friend of your father?
Vietnam,
That's a leading question. It's suggesting an answer
that
it has no basis.
I'm first asking and I'm not trying to refresh his memory. Does that ring a bell, Mr. Witness, what I'm telling you?
Mr. Witness,
I will, Mr. President, but I first asked it in an open way, and he said he didn't remember the name, and now I'm trying to indeed lead him a bit in the hope that it will somehow jog his memory. Mr. Witness, Hay Su, old friend of your father, Vietnamese expert in guerrilla warfare, him meeting with your father between
75
and
79,
does it ring a bell?
In
75 and 79, he went to the country.
Your father didn't meet him in May 77? Mr. Witness, let me read you an excerpt from a statement of a witness who used to be your foster son, your foster father's, excuse me, bodyguard. Mr. Witness, Mr. President, excuse me. I'm referring to E319/19.3.107. English year M00970079, French 01044643, and Khmer 09606676. The question Mr. Witness put to this person, who was somebody who was very close, it seems, to your foster father, is the following. On 17 April 75, where were you living and what were you doing? And he answers A3. On 17 April 75, I moved to live in Kangat until 76, when Tanim invited me to be his bodyguard. I was his bodyguard until he was arrested. I escorted and secured his safety everywhere he went. He had three bodyguards, including me, but I was not the one who got in the car with him. I used to escort Tan Nim to Phnom Den Mountain, which is bordered by Vietnam. Question: why did you escort Tan Nim to Phnom Den Mountain? And then he answers: he needed me to secure him while he was transporting military uniforms from Phnom Den Mountain to Ampil Prahong and Sisophon in 1977. Sisophon was also Tan Nim's military base. Question: what place was Ampil Prahong? Ampil Prahong answer was Tan Nim's house and office. Ampil Prahong was 1 kilometer west of Psa Lu Market. Question: what were those military uniforms transported for? Answer: I did not know for whom those uniforms were transported, but Tan Nim told me those uniforms had come from Vietnam. Were you fetching the uniforms from Phnom Den Mountain? Was there fighting along the Vietnam border yet? There had not been any fighting yet. Now, Mr. Witness, a little further down, he is being questioned by security people as to the reasons why your foster father was receiving uniforms, military uniforms from Vietnam. Do you know anything about that?
Đời rung chạ tầm ba anh khai bắt tầm bong khuôn ai này hai chân luộc. Phải mặc lư chân luộc. Sạc sân cây, đam sân cây chân luộc. Sạc sân nôl bọc chân luộc ao việc khmau tao phần năng. Nhưng dù khá ao bị cao mà ọt miên thế mà.
Mr. Witness, did you know at the time, or maybe later when you were studying in the Soviet Union, or later when you were working closely with Vietnamese military troops, that in February 1978, the full plenum of the Central Committee of the Vietnamese Communist Party decided to start an internal uprising led by Soe Pim, and if that wouldn't work, ultimately to invade Cambodia. Have you heard at the time anything about that, or have you heard while you were in the Soviet Union anything about that?
Monsieur le Président, juste une remarque, est-ce qu'on peut savoir d'où notre confrère tire cette information qu'il a déjà essayé d'utiliser dans le procès 2-2, il a été incapable de nous fournir la source, est-il possible qu'on comprenne d'où cette information est sortie pour que nous puissions éventuellement la regarder, la lire, la contredire, poser éventuellement des questions aux témoins sur cette information? Nous ne savons absolument pas d'où cela sort.
Your Honor, my objection is different. It is absolutely irrelevant to the appeal of 2-1. Now we're getting into whether Vietnam had plans in 1978 to invade Cambodia, and it's clearly beyond the scope of the issues in case 2-1, which, as my colleague previously pointed out, the temporal scope ends in 1977.
Mr. President, if I may reply, two objections are, I suppose, both troubling on various levels. Troubling is that civil party lawyers still does not seem to know, which by now is common knowledge, that this decision was made in February 78. It is documented extensively by the court's expert, Nayan Chanda. He wrote about it in 78-79 in the Far Eastern Economic Review. He wrote about it in his book, which was extensively discussed in the first trial. Other scholars have confirmed this. I don't think there's any doubt whatsoever that this fourth plan did indeed come together in February 78. In relation to the objection of the prosecution, I have no idea how to put that in any perspective. I think the decision of Vietnam is crucial, and the role of Vietnam is crucial to understanding anything as to what happened in DK between 75 and 79. It's certainly not outside the scope of this trial. I would just like to remind you that although the severance decision is an incomprehensible one, there's no doubt about that. If you go, that is the reality to the actual judgment. The last document, I actually did some research this weekend, the last document in time that was used by the trial chamber dates from January 79, which is a communications to the United Nations. There are many documents, S21 documents, with the date all the way to August 78. So now to stand up and pretend like this is a severance issue or outside of the scope issue is ridiculous. I'm sorry to use that word again.
Monsieur le Président,
si je... ខ្ញុំពិនិត្យមើលទៅឃើញចេះឃើញថាការលើកឡើងរបស់មេតាវីម៉ាញ់មិញនេះគឺថាវាមានប្រភពឯកសារប៉ុន្តែគឺតកតើនឹងបញ្ហាអង្គហេតុដែលគាត់លើកឡើងមិញនេះគឺខ្ញុំពិនិត្យទៅឃើញថាវាមិនមានការពាក់ព័ន្ធជាមួយនឹងបណ្ដឹងសារទុកទេតកតើនឹងបញ្ហាសំខាន់គឺអីដែលគាត់លើកមិញនេះគឺតកតើបញ្ហាវៀតណាមប៉ុន្តែគឺថាលោកអាចរោគសំណួរផ្សេងទៀតដើម្បីសួរទៅសាក់សីបានប៉ុន្តែគឺវាឲ្យកុំឲ្យវាហួសពីវិសាលភាពខ្លាំងពេកបាទឲ្យវាមានភាពពាក់ព័ន្ធខ្លះបាទសូមអញ្ជើញឯកសារបើសិនជាលក្ខណៈជាឯកសារដែលមានលេខយោងគឺសូមបញ្ជាក់មកផងបាទ
To answer that first question, of course, Mr. President, we put on record E3/2376, English ERN 001924 01, French 0023708080, and in Khmer 0019155 0. That's an excerpt from Nayan Chanda's book called Brother Enemy. So we did document this decision beforehand, Mr. President. In relation to the question in itself, I have noticed that you have given a decision without consultation of the bench. This is such a principled matter for us. I would like you to confer with your fellow judges and to reason and argue about this question that is very crucial to us. And if you forbid me, then so be it. But I would like you to have a debate within the chamber.
ខ្ញុំគិតបញ្ជាក់អំពីលោកមេធាវីបានច្បាស់ថាតកតើនឹងបញ្ហាម្បាញ់មិញនេះគឺយើងខ្ញុំមិនជំទាស់ថាមិនអោយមេធាវីសួរទេប៉ុន្តែគិតតែការសួរសំណួរហ្នឹងគឺអាចជ្រើសវិធីផ្សេងហើយការវិធីដែលលោកជ្រើសរើសហ្នឹងធ្វើម៉េចកុំអោយវាស៊ីជម្រៅរហូតទៅដល់អង្គហេតុដែលมันមានភាពពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងរឿងក្តីហើយបញ្ហានេះខ្ញុំនឹងពិភាក្សាគ្នាឡើងវិញម្ដងទៀត
អ
Then I apologize for not understanding well your decision, Mr. President. Let me rephrase or try to rephrase my question. Mr. Witness, were you at the time or later while you were in the Soviet Union aware of a February 1978 decision of the fourth plenum of the Central Committee of the Vietnamese Communist Party to start an internal rebellion led by Sao Pim, and if that would not work, to invade democratic Cambodia? Do you know anything about that? When you were in the Soviet Union studying at the Military Academy, were you ever being taught about the Soviet invasion of Czechoslovakia in
1968?
Mr. Witness, let me read to you minutes of a meeting of all commanders of the Central Armies, minutes of the meeting of October 76, led by Son Sen, President E3/13, English ERN 009-40343, Khmer 0005-2406 and French 00334976. Now Son Sen is addressing all commanders of the center's divisions, and he says the following, and I quote: "The enemy to the east, the key plan of the enemy of the east, the Vietnamese, with the Soviets behind them, was to attack from the inside through the traitorous forces of Ya, Khieu Mas, Chuk, and Chakrai. What they would have liked in terms of an attack from the outside was to attack in Czechoslovakian and Angolan style. But this was merely a morale boost, because given our situation, this was not something the enemy could do. Have you ever heard something to that effect in 76? Vietnam suggesting maybe to your father or others, that Vietnam would do a 68 kind of Czechoslovakia style attack?" This same expert of this court, Nayan Chanda, wrote in his book that he had talked to a Vietnamese general in 78, who told him that in fact this had been the advice of the Soviet Union to Vietnam in early 78. Do you know anything about this? Were you ever told this while you were at the Military Academy in the Soviet Union?
Mr.
So witness, let me read to you an excerpt from another Northwest Zone country. Mr. President, that would be E319/13.3.58, English ERN 00970467, French 00974761, and Khmer 00947282. Question. Did you know, question 13, by the way, did you know why the Southwest cadres came to replace the Northwest cadres? Answer of this Northwest Zone cadre. They had been accused of being affiliated with the Viet Minh Khmer Rouge and the East Zone Committee Chief Sao Pim. These two zones had turned against Pol Pot. According to my observations, the Khmer Rouge was apparently composed of three or four groups. The first group was the Viet Minh. The second group was the nationalistic Khmer Rouge. The third was the Sihanouk Khmer Rouge, and the fourth group was the Khmer Rouge from China, including Pol Pot. Now, Mr. Witness, this fellow Northwest Zone cadre is speaking about various factions within the CPK. Is that your recollection as well? Were you, in fact, yourself a member of one of those four factions backed by Vietnam, which was trying to rebel and start an armed conflict with the group led by Pol Pot? But did Sao Pim or Runim, Mr. Witness, I would like now to turn to your arrest that you just briefly described already. Mr. President, as you have noticed, I'm already busy for 2 hours, but I need some substantial more time, which this time I don't think can be solved with giving the defense 10 minutes extra. So I would kindly ask your permission to continue
Your Honors, we would ask the court not to grant that for a simple reason. This is not a retrial. Counsel is raising issues that are completely irrelevant. He's wasted his time talking about Czechoslovakia in 1968 and what this witness studied in the 1980s and hasn't gone to any issues that are really on appeal. So it's, if there's a problem with time, it's because the defense has not focused on the appeal issues.
Chúng tạm cả phía xa nữa thả ảnh nhạt ở lúc mệt vì những bắt to đọc những tí tiết mà sống trên. Some change look maybe.
10 minutes, that's what I get.
Look with him and yet I can sue up with the allowing myself occurring.
Mr. Witness, you said earlier that you had been arrested at one point in time. What happened after your arrest? Where were you detained?
Cry pel chap clun look on bong, kum clun look no.
បានកាប់ចាប់ខ្លួនខ្ញុំលើកទី1នោះគេថាវាមិនបានខ្លួនខ្ញុំពិតប្រកបទេព្រោះធ្វើដំណើរទៅពីអ្នកខ្ញុំជីកង់មុខអនុប្រធានកម្មានោះគឺជីកង់ពីក្រោយពីចាប់បានអ្នកក្រោយហើយគេយកទៅសួរគេវាយសួរចម្លើយសពមុខ ສູ່ເຮົາຊົມຂ້ອຍນັ້ນດາຊາຍທໍາແມ່ນເດກໍຢູ່ຕະສູ້ຈຽງມັນຊັ້ນຕຶກຊັ້ນຖືກຈຽງມັນຊັ້ນບົມຕຶກນັ້ນຊາຍນັ້ນມັນປັບທໍາມັນແມ່ນຂ້ອຍເດບານກິປະເລງມາໄວປະເລງເດຂ້ອຍກິຈັບອັດບານເດບາດ
And where were you detained? after your arrest, Mr. Witness?
Kroy pel chap khluon lok ke khum khluon lok nung kroy chap khluon ke khum lok nai na.
Khyom ban prab tha ke chap khyom mon ban te chap chalom khyom. Chap chom anupathean bok khyom. Kia mình ban vô tờ khum na tí cái vay su nâng mong. Vay su đó về khâu một nhóm cái bà lên mà mình. Bán đăng đó khi nhóm, ở khi nhóm coi. Hai cơ ma không có bà bạch chiêm hồ chiêm nâng. Hai cơ ma bọc lạc tương khai đạp bài. Đạp bà bật ỏi tâu hai khi nhóm bẹp thật tế ai nó ná tâu nông tâu. Bánh nâu tí tê. Bánh nó chung nghe tí tê. Tôi sốc tập phùm mình cho. Cái này là để tao bàn sốc. Chẳng cái kia mình chạp bàn khi không tê.
Bàn nó xạ xấy.
Let me interrupt you, Mr. Witness. Let me read to you a passage from this Northwest Zone cadre who I referred to earlier. Mr. President, that is document E319/13.3.17. English N0978422, French 01004436, Khmer 0095196. Question. You talked about Daham. What was Daham's position during the Khmer Rouge regime? Answer. Daham was deputy of the zone military staff. He was Takhmer's deputy. Question. Do you know what happened to Daham? Answer. Daham was also arrested. They were arrested together. I obtained information that both divisions of the Northwest Zone had planned to fight back against Pol Pot, but this plan had been leaked through some agents of the center. That's why, that was why the military people were arrested. Daham was accused of having transported military equipment to Phnom via Chap Mountain. I learned about this after 79 from a driver who had transported the equipment in question. Another soldier told me of a hearing the leaders say in a meeting that if nothing was done about the Northwest group, the zone would revolt like the East Zone. Mr. Witness, were you arrested together with Kleng and were you accused of having transported military equipment that we just discussed?
มาคือที่จับครูนขยมออดบานเตให้อาวุธได้ยั่วตะตุกนั้นคือนิยายดีสิซ้อมดาวแทนมันบ้านยั่วตะเลี่ยตุกดำไปไปชังหนึ่งปลโปเตคือแต่ซาตุกเอาอยู่บานอ๋อแต่กลายปลโปเธอบาปเข้มกระจับเข้มจับเป็นบ้านคือเข้มก็สมัยจัดโยบทหนึ่งปลาวิ่งเตอร์ไปเบาะวิ่งเตอร์บ้าน
Mr. Witness, after your arrest, how many men did you lead into the forest to start openly armed conflict with central troops? When exactly was that?
Tâu để bùm bùn nè, thằng chất thả thươi cháu đi. Cháu lùi sâu thả co xí nông. Mà tôi dây xí chăng cho cả nâng hào xí chăng. Hộp mà. Mà cậu chăm vay tấu. Vay bụ để tư múc tư mọt chăm bật tiê. Bụ mà rồi bùm bay chanh tấu. Về lưng cứ bạn. Con chả lách, và tấu, mê con, có tấu rất tạm, bị khói, rất tạm chôn cho mùi buộc chống, ពេលហ្នឹងគឺធ្វើឲ្យខ្ញុំហ្នឹងថាមានទឹកចិត្តបកើតកងទ័ពឡើងវិញហើយកងចល័តក៏គាត់និយាយថាគាត់នៅក៏ងាប់ទៅហ្នឹងក៏ងាប់បើមកហ្នឹងមានកំភ្លើងតស៊ូគាត់អាចនឹងរស់បានយូរអញ្ចឹងខ្ញុំក៏បរៀនគាត់កាន់កំភ្លើងទៅហើយខ្ញុំក៏សម្រេចចិត្តទៅយកក្លឹងកំភ្លើងហ្នឹងមកប្រើវិញទៅ
Mr. Witness, let me interrupt you. Let me summarize your own testimony to the investigators and then tell me if I summarize it adequately. Did you at one point in time flee into the forest with 2,000 men and that all sectors of the Northwest Zone came under your control except Sector 7, that you started open fighting against Southwest Zone troops
and at one point in time you
លោកបានធ្វើការតាក់ទងជាមួយឈូកមកពីពុំពាក់ពុំពាក់ដែលដឹកនាំកងតបមកពុំពាក់ពុំពាក់ដែលដឹកនាំដោយហេងសំរិនតើអញ្ចឹងដែរឬក៏ទេមកគឺការតស៊ូនេះវាមិនមែនមានអង្គការចាត់តាំងណាទេដូចខ្ញុំនិយាយថាទៅតែ 9 នាក់ទេដបងនោះដល់តែពេលគេរត់ទៅច្រើនតាមខ្ញុំទៅក៏ធ្វើខ្ញុំមានទឹកចិត្តនឹងរៀបកម្លាំងតស៊ូឡើងវិញនៅតាមតំបន់មួយមួយចាត់តាំងជាមេកងតំបន់ឡើងវិញដើរជើសរើសទៅហ៊ានចាស់ដែលគេយកទៅលុតដំកាប់ចំការនៅភ្នំបិចាបកាប់ចំការនៅត្បែងនេះគេដក
អ៎ថ្ងៃហ្នឹងគេយកទៅលុតដំហ្នឹងអញ្ចឹងខ្ញុំប្រមូលគ្នាបានតែ2000នាក់នឹងទាហានចាស់ហើយបូកនឹងកងចល័តរត់ជួលវឹកវើនបន្ថែមហើយជិះចប់ 20,000 នាក់បាទប៉ុណ្ណឹងអញ្ចឹងអត់
លោកបានទំនាក់ទំនងជាមួយកងទ័ពភូមិភាគបូព៌ាដែលដឹកនាំដោយហេងសំរិនដែលថាលោកជាមួយនឹងកម្លាងរបស់ហេងសំរិនណាបានប្រជិតជាមួយនឹងកងទ័ពភូមិភាគនិរដីតើត្រឹមត្រូវដែរឬទេណាត់ការតាក់ទងជាមួយនឹងលោកតាហេងសំរិន ខាងរណសេសាមគ្គីសង្គ្រោះជាតិនោះគឺក្រោយពេលដែលគាត់ទៅដល់កងទ័ពរណសេទៅដល់ខេត្តបាត់ដំបងទេកាលមុនខ្ញុំអត់ដឹងទេខ្ញុំថាមានតែខ្ញុំទេអញ្ចឹងថាវាជាឯកោរស៊ីរស់តាមដំណើរមានអីវាយបានប្រមាណហូបប៉ុណ្ណឹងដល់អញ្ចឹងទៅក៏ទ័ពមួយឆឹមហ្នឹងក៏ទៅលើកទី1ហ្នឹងខ្ញុំវាយបាក់អស់ទៅ ແລະបាត់អស់ទៅអញ្ចឹងខ្ញុំក៏បានសុកសានបានពីខែ3ខែដែរដល់ទៅលើក្រោយទៅវាយវាយវាយបាញ់គ្នាយូរយូរទៅវាចេះតែច្រើនទៅច្រើនទៅខ្ញុំអត់ដឹងថាវារត់ពីពេញទៅណាអត់ដឹងថារណសេដេញពីពេញហើយមកដឹងទេដល់សួរចាប់បានដល់សួរថាមានរណសេសាមគ្គីសង្គ្រោះជាតិមានប៉ែនសវណ្ណជាស៊ីមហីអើហេងវិនជាស៊ីមអញ្ចឹងទៅ
I have many more questions to you about this open-armed conflict, Mr. Witness, but my last question will be about the arrest of your foster father, there is a witness who testified before the investigators that your foster father learned about his pending arrest, escaped to Sisyphon, and was arrested in Sisyphon by armed units using a helicopter. Is that correct?
ខ្ញុំ អត់ ដឹង ទេ ប៉ុន្តែ កាលនោះ អត់ មាន ធម្មកិច្ចទេ វា អស់ ហើយ chun hok ot min dae ye slo phal slo slap pre slo ai hoy bat hai pel dai chap khluon kot ko mon dang tha chap no na dae khom ot dang dae bo khom to prei phor dae
Thank you, Mr. Witness. Mr. President, for the record, I have not asked any questions to the witness yet about the attack 75 on Pursat provincial town. What happened with the soldiers at Tupotray? So maybe if I make my request very specific and ask for permission for about 20-25 minutes to only ask questions in relation to
ដើម្បីសួរតែសំណួរតាក់ទងទៅនឹងការវាយប្រហារចូលទីរួមខេត្តពោធិ៍សាត់និងអ្វីដែលបានកើតឡើងជាបន្តបន្ទាប់លើទាហានដែលវាយប្រយុទ្ធដើម្បីរបបលន់នល់នោះលោកមេធាវីខ្ញុំសូមបញ្ជាក់លោកមេធាវីបន្តិចតាក់ទងមិញនេះគឺដំបងលោកថាសុំ10នាទីហើយគាត់ត្រូវការនឹងចង់សុំបន្ថែមរហូតដល់1ម៉ោងទៀត ប៉ុន្តែមិញនេះគឺលោកថាសុំ20ទៅ30ចឹងអា20ទៅ30នាទីបន្ថែមនេះគឺសម្រាប់បញ្ចប់ត្មងឬក៏ត្រឹមតែសួរមួយផ្នែកនឹងទេសួរបញ្ជាក់ច្បាស់ឥឡូវបើសិនអីចឹងទេលោកអាចថាឥឡូវសុំជាទូទៅហ្នឹងគឺប្រមាណតែម្ដងសុំបន្ថែមបាទ
Maybe something went wrong in the translation, Mr. President. I asked for an hour, and then you decided to give me 10 minutes. So maybe that wasn't clear. What I'm asking now is another 20-25 minutes, and I will, I promise, limit myself to questions in relation to Pursat and the attack on Pursat, and what happened to
ចេះខ្ញុំសូមបញ្ជាក់បន្ថែមថា 20 ទៅ 25 ឬក៏ 30 នាទីដែលសូមបន្ថែមហ្នឹងគឺបញ្ចប់ទាំងអស់តែម្ដងឬក៏តែមួយផ្នែកទេ
Yes
មេធាវីកូពេបានលោកប្រធានគឺសូមសរុបបញ្ចប់តែម្ដង
Thank you very much
សូមអរគុណ
Mr. Witness, let me take you back now to March, April 75. What do you remember of the attack?
ចេះលោកមេធាវីគឺឥឡូវយើងដល់ពេលវេលាសម្រាកហើយអញ្ចឹងសំណើរបស់លោកថាសុំ20ទៅ30នាទីហ្នឹងគឺអង្គជំនុំជម្រះនឹងពេលទៅហូបបាយនឹងសម្រេចអំពីពេលវេលាហ្នឹងពីពេលវេលាហើយខ្ញុំជំរាបផងដែរថា សាក់សីទាត់ធឿនគាត់អាចមានពេលវេលាដើម្បីឆ្លើយនឹងសកម្មភាពនៅពេលនេះអញ្ចឹងនៅពេលនេះគឺតឡាការប្រកាសសម្រាកសិនហើយលោកមន្ត្រីខាងពន្ធនាគារសូមបាទជួយជួយ
To both Council of the Defense, considering the course of the interviewing of the witness so far and the interest of the clients, would you be capable of agreeing as to the use of time after the break for the defense?
Je ne comprends pas bien votre question, Madame le juge. Effectivement, il est possible qu'il me reste du temps de disponible à la fin de mes questions et à ce moment-là, je laisserai ce temps disponible à mon confrère Victor Copé. Tant que je n'ai pas entendu les questions qu'il a l'intention de poser sur un sujet qui m'intéresse aussi beaucoup, c'est un peu difficile de voir, mais je ne reposerai pas les mêmes questions, ça va de soi.
Merci. we were asking because we know that we are behind the schedule. We started later, and also we remember that there was a request from the prosecution and civil parties for the additional time, which we turned down. But in light of the how the questioning goes, we would need to consider this as well. So we just wanted to have all this data before we go to break to decide on the timing issue.
Thank you, Judge. I will limit myself to 20-25 minutes,
and then we'll have time
for the question and the and then the ជូនមកវិញនៅនាំមកវិញនៅវេលាម៉ោង